بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والحمد لله رب العالمين بارئ الخلائق أجمعين باعث الأنبياء والمرسلين ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين حبيب إله العالمين المصطفى أبي القاسم محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله، السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله، السلام عليك يا غريب كربلاء، السلام على الدماء السائلات، السلام على الشفاه الذابلات، السلام على الرأس المرفوع على القناة، السلام على النساء الثاكلات، السلام على الأجساد بالدماء مغسلات. After the martyrdom of Imam al-Husayn عليه السلام, the enemies of Allah started attacking the tents of Abi Abdullah al-Husayn. Abu Hamza al-Thumali, one of the companions of Imam al-Sajjad salamullahi alayh, says, one day I came to visit the Imam. I saw him weeping and crying in pain for his father Abi Abdullah al-Husayn. I tried to console him to ease his pain. So I said, oh my master, Allah has blessed you, Ahl al-Bayt, with martyrdom. Look at your grandfather, Amir al-Mu'mineen, your uncle, Imam al-Hasan. And Allah has also honored your father with shahada, martyrdom. Imam looked at me and said, may Allah have mercy on you, Ya Aba Hamza. It is true that Allah has honored us with martyrdom, but every time I look at my aunts, I look at my sisters, I remember them running on the day of Ashura from one tent to another tent as the enemies of Allah call out, burn the tents of Hussein. He says, my aunt Zainab came to me at that moment, said, what shall we do? I told her, my aunt, take the women and the children and run away from the fire to the desert. Just keep them protected from the fire. One of the enemies, a man by the name of Hamid ibn Muslim, says, I saw a lady standing by a tent, and the fire surrounds her from all sides. I called her, lady, the fire is catching on to your clothes. She looked at me and said, O enemy of Allah, I see the fire, but we have a sick man in this tent that I must protect and defend. بس العليل ظل شريد يصفج وسف يا حسين بيد ينادي وين ابويا اليوم اريد While Zainab alayha salam is taking care of the women and the children on one side, she sees Umar ibn Sa'd calling his army, calling some knights, and saying, Who is there to crush the body of Abi Abdullah al-Husayn? She saw the horses of Bani Umayyah running over the body of Abi Abdullah. She ran to a nearby hill that is today called Tal al-Zainabiyyah. Stood there, turned towards Medina and cried, Ya Jaddah, Hada Husaynuka fil Aram, Maslub al-Imayamati wal-Ridaya. محزوز الرأس من القفايا Oh my grandfather, this is your beloved Hussein lying on the plains of Karbala. His turban has been taken away by the enemies of Allah. His clothes taken away by the enemies of Allah. He is under the horses of Bani Umayyah. Hamid ibn Muslim says, I saw a little girl of Abi Abdullah al-Husayn. Hamid ibn Muslim was one of the enemies, one of the people with a hard heart, one of the people who participated in the killing of Imam al-Husayn. But he says, when I saw this little girl, I felt sorry for her. So I approached her, I told her, little girl, where are you going? When she saw me, she got scared and said, are you here to raid me, to take my earrings away from my ears? I told her, no, I saw you in despair, I felt sorry for you. Are you with us or against us? I'm neither for you or against you. What do you want, little girl? She said, if you are able to help me, I want you to take me to Najaf. I asked her, little girl, what do you want in Najaf? She said, I heard my aunt Zainab saying, we have a grave in Najaf. Whenever someone is in distress and goes to him, he will help them. I want to go and tell him that our tents are up in flames. I want to tell him that my father Hussein doesn't have a head anymore on his body. I want to tell him that my aunt Zainab is getting beaten by Shimra and Zajr. He said, little girl, Najaf is too far, I cannot take you to Najaf. She said, then can you take me to the river of Furat? I said, yes, there I can take you. So I led her to the river of Furat. The minute the girl arrived there, she went to the body of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. She cried, Amma ya Abu al-Fadl, ya ابو فاضل قوم لينا يا عمي حرقه وخيمنا علينا علينا او ماي انكل عباس don't you see the tents are up in flames and my aunt Zainab is crying ايوا عباس زينب عليها السلام بنت she turned to عمر بن سعد and said يا ابن سعد now that you killed حسين can you give the children of حسين some water as they're dying of thirst then he said all right he ordered his men to bring water for the children of أبي عبد الله and his family when they poured the water for the children The little girl Ruqayya said, my aunt, I know my father is thirsty. I want to take this water to him. Zainab alayha salam said, Ruqayya, my beloved, Your father's thirst has been quenched. You drink the water, my little girl. Then Zainab alayha salam started looking after the women and the children as Imam Hussein told her and asked her to do on his final moments when she stood next to him. He said, Zainab, take care of my women and children. تقول له يا خويا انا بعيني لباري لك عيالك يا خويا يا نور العين وبروحي لخلي لك اطفالك So she started looking for the women and the children, gathering them in one place. As at this point, there are no more tents left. They all have been taken over by the flames. So she gathered them in one area, looking around. Where is Sukaina, the daughter of Abi Abdullah? I do not see her. She heads to the battlefield. As she enters the battlefield, she sees the bodies with severed heads, severed hands, covered in blood, covered in arrows and spears. She makes her way to the body of Abi Abdullah al-Husayn. Sukaina's right there crying, Aywa Bataya wa Husayna. I wonder if Sukaina was hugging the body, because I don't know how would she be hugging a body covered in arrows. أثار الأبو يا ناس خيمة يفيع على بناته وحريم بويا يا بويا يا 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 والدي والله عظيم أنا أصير من زغري يتيم بويا والنوح من عقبك لجيم سكينة my little girl what are you doing here she said my aunt Zainab when I saw the tents going up in flames I said let me seek refuge in my father Abi Abdullah but I saw him a body without a head So Zainab alayha salam comforted the little girl, took her back to where she kept the women and the children. As the night started to fall, looking around, making sure everyone is here. Then she notices Ramla, the mother of Qasim, is not there. She goes out seeking her, finds her lying down next to the body of her son. Bunay قاسم يا ابني أنا قطعت منك نصيبي يا ابني ردتك ذخر الأيام شيبي رملة what are you doing here يا زينب I know tomorrow we're leaving I want to see my son this final night but he's next to Fatima she's taking care of him now he's next to his father his uncle his grandfather Rasulullah I know يا زينب but he was so young I just want to see him I know he's covered in blood This one final night. She comforts Ramla, brings her back again to where everyone is. Then Zainab alayha salam notices a man roaming around the area where the women and the children are staying. She goes to him and tells him, Who are you? What are you doing here? He says, Umar ibn Sa'd ordered me to guard you over this night. She cried and said, أَفَمِن بَعْدِ عَيْنِ أَبِ الْفَضْلِ أَنْتَ الَّذِي تَحْرُسُنَا يَا يَا After Abbas, you're the one who's guarding us. You can leave, Allah will protect us. But before you go, I am missing a lady. Have you seen one lady anywhere? He said, no, I haven't, but I heard some cries coming from that direction. Zainab heads towards that direction. Who does she find? She finds the mother of Ali al-Asghar. Carrying her baby on her chest. Rabab, what brings you here? Zainab, when they gave us the water, only mothers know this feeling. The mothers know what she feels. When I drank the water, I felt the milk coming to me. It was time for my baby to feed. Ya bni, ya bni darran thidaya. أنا لو ندرت روح لجل الماء كان سقيتك بدمع عيناي I came, I saw maybe, I thought maybe there is still life in my baby to have some food. But I saw him with his the arrow in his throat from one end to the other end, Ya Zainab. She said, Rabab, he is now with his grandfather, Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, being cared for. Come back with me, Ya Rabab. She brings her back. Once all the women and the children have settled down, Zainab alayha salam turns to her musalla and starts praying Salatul Layl. Look, Ya Mu'mineen, how much Zainab loves the Salat. This is what we need to learn from her, taking care of our Salat. Even in these difficult tragedies and this difficult night, she does not even let go of Salatul Layl. But Imam al-Sajjad notices Zainab alayha salam praying the salat while sitting down, not standing up. My aunt Zainab, why are you praying while sitting down? Every night you pray standing. My beloved nephew, I lost my strength tonight. I have no more power. She finished her salat. At this point, some of the children have gone to sleep. Some of the women have rested. Now she got up. She started walking. Zainab, where are you going at this time? I need to bid farewell to my brother Abbas. أنا رايح العباية أسجع وركب جفوف فوق زندية وقل لي يا أخويا الحرم طاحت بشدة خويا تعنيت لك واللون مخطوف وعضاي تتراجف من الخايف أنا ردتك الحال وللذي تشوف خويا لقيت العلم عن نار ملفوف خويا عذرتك من شفت ما عندك جفوف I am heading to Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. She goes there. This is where the poets now draw this kind of picture. Zainab is sitting next to Abu al-Fadl talking to him. Brother Abbas, you're the one who brought me from Medina. Brother Abbas, why did you leave without bidding farewell to me? I wish you were awakened now to see Shimr and Zajr beating me. It is as if Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas replies back to her, telling her, Zainab, forgive your brother Abbas. Zainab, they cut off my right hand. They cut off my left hand. They shot me with an arrow in my eye, ya Zainab. تعتبين يا زينب علي أنا وين راسي وين يدي لكن يا زينب شبيدي أخوك وتدرين الحرب عيدي لو أن كانت تنوش السيف إيدي ما كان ظل وحده عضيدي نذرا علي لئن عادوا وإن رجعوا لأزرعن طريق الطف ريحان